devotees to our Bhakti Sangha Japa conference call. Today we are having Her Grace Kirtida Sundari Mataji to enlighten on the topic of Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela. So we are very fortunate to have Mataji on the call today with us. So Hare Krishna Kirtida Mataji, I once again welcome to the call. Thank you so much Mataji for giving your valuable association and enlightening on the topic of Chaitanya Charitamrita Antya Leela. So now I hand over the call to you Mataji. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Shyama Supriya Mataji. Thank you all so much for so warmly introducing everybody. And thank you everyone for joining us today. Thank you for all your wonderful association. So let's start. Just want to make sure, am I audible?
Yes, you are, Mataji.
Okay. Thank you. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. We are reading from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Leela, Antya Leela, Chapter 1, entitled Rupa Goswami's Second Meeting with the Lord. And today we'll start with text number 118. Prabhu kahe kaha rupa natake ra shloka ye shloka sunile loke ra yaya dukha shoka. Translation. Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, My dear Rupa, please recite that verse from your drama, which upon being heard makes all people's unhappiness and lamentation go away. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namah Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Rubhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Charu Swami Niti Namine Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Deshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivas Adi Gaura Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Guruve Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namaha. So Hare Krishna, dear devotees, thank you so much for giving your valuable time and coming on to the call, attending the sessions, chanting so beautifully. So thank you all so much, really indebted to each and every one of you. And as usual, I'll simply pray to each and every one of your lotus feet to please don't be miser, just shower your immense blessings, prayers, wishes, so that I can speak this so esoteric subject matter of which even I have not even touched. So this subject matter is so deep and I'm still on surface floating, but just hoping that with your blessings and prayers, I will able to render some service. So I really seek blessings to each and every one of you. Vancha kalpatarubhascha kripa sindhubha evacha patita nam pavane pyo vaishnave bhyo namo namo. Anantakoti vaishnavrindi ki jai. Okay, so just to give me a few seconds. Okay, so we are in Antya Leela. So till now, we saw that how Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, being so pleased with the work of Rupa Goswami, he started praising him. And he's praising in front of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Rai Ramananda, just to examine them, that how a devotee feels when some other devotee is pleased in front of, is glorified in front of them, or is praised in before them. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the setting is that he is in the kutir of Haridas Thakur at Siddha Bakula, along with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Rai Ramananda. So this time he is not only with Haridas Thakur and Rupa Goswami, but now he is in the kutir of Haridas Thakur with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Ramananda Rai. And then he told Rupa Goswami, can you recite that verse which you composed, you know, revealing my heart, my innermost confidential heart. Can you recite that verse? Remember, we discussed that verse, you know, that Rupa Goswami wrote when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was chanting in front of Jagannath. And then Rupa Goswami, understanding the most confidential heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he immediately recited that verse. So, you know, Rupa Goswami, on orders of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, recited, and hearing that verse, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Rai Ramananda, you know, he said, they both actually agreed and admitted that, yes, you are the one who has really revealed the heart of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then they were actually struck with wonder after hearing that verse. But they also admitted that it's only and only because of the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that you are able to understand and as well as compose this beautiful verse. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Rupa Goswami to recite another verse that the drama from, you know, you are, which in which you wrote. And Rupa Goswami, somewhat, you know, he felt shy, but Mahaprabhu requested him again and again to recite that verse. And then Rupa Goswami recited that famous verse, you know. Tunde tandavani ratim vitanute tundavali labdhaye karina krodha kadambini ghatayate karinar budhaya ishpriham cheta prangana sangini vijayate sarvendriyanam kritim no jane janita kriya viramrita krishneti varnadoi. He said that this word Krishna is so important. The two syllable Krishna, they are filled with immense, you know, love, an immense, deep, ecstatic love. So, you know, when Rupa Goswami recited this verse, everybody was struck with wonder, because these two syllables Krishna has so much deep meaning into it. As Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in his Madhya Leela, he writes, Krishi bhu vachako shabdo naste nivritti vachaka. So Krishi, the Krish word, the Krishna actually, it's a bhu vachako. It's a two syllable word, Krish and Na. So Krish, tayor akyam param brahma krishneti adi iti abhish diyate. So the word Krishna is the attractive feature, Krish, one who attracts, you know. So Krish refers to the attractive features of the Lord, and Na refers to the Ananda potency, the, what do you say, the spiritual pleasure, Ananda. It refers to that spiritual pleasure. So when this verb Krish is added to the affix Na, it becomes Krishna, which indicates this absolute truth. So we have discussed this in detail. So we'll definitely not go in detail with it because we have already discussed. So when all the devotees, especially Ramananda Rai, he heard that verse, and you know, they actually all filled with transcendental bliss and were struck in wonder with every, you know, that how they were discussing with each other, that they have never heard such kind of description of the holy name of this word Krishna. And then Rai Ramananda, he then inquired Rupa Goswami, what kind of drama are you writing? So Rupa Goswami, you know, he still hesitated because out of humility, he doesn't want to say anything that, oh, he's writing some drama. So here is the lesson that, you know, we all have to imbibe, that we should stop boasting our works. You know, we not, you know, we develop this kind of attitude that, you know, when we do something special, when we write something special, or when we do any kind of survey, we start boasting ourselves, putting on our Facebooks and our Twitter and our Instagram, you know, that, oh, I chanted this much rounds on Ekadashis, and I did this much, and I did this service. So Srila Prabhupada is warning us through this example of Rupa Goswami, that who are we? We are just insignificant souls. And see the work of Rupa Goswami. His work is basically drowning everybody, drowning all the inhabitants of this loka. Not only this loka, all the universes. They are being drowned in the works, in the love, in the ecstatic feeling of Rupa Goswami. And still Rupa Goswami is so humble at heart. Because when Rai Ramananda, he told, can you please just tell what kind of drama are you writing? If he would have been myself, I would have all said, oh, this is what, you know, I'm writing, and this is, these are my thoughts, and, you know, so and so forth. But here, Rupa Goswami is getting so humble, and he said, oh, I don't know, you know, because he was speechless. He doesn't want to speak about anything because he felt himself to be utmost unqualified, especially in front of Ramananda Rai, who's a great dramatist. But here, Rupa Goswami, he's writing this drama. He's writing these two natakas, Vidagdha Madhava and Lalita Madhava. But still, you know, he was feeling himself to be utmost unqualified in front of Ramananda Rai. And he was speechless. He didn't say anything. And then hearing, you know, Swarup Damodar Goswami, then he started replying on behalf of Rupa Goswami that how he was planning to write one drama about Krishna's pastimes in Vrindavan and Dwarka and Mathura. But now, you know, following the orders of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he decided to divide his drama into two parts. And he's writing now two-part drama, that is Vidagdha Madhava and Lalita Madhava. However, he said that both of the dramas, they are completely, both the dramas actually completely describe the ecstatic emotional love of God. And hearing this, Rai Ramananda requested Rupa Goswami, can you please recite the introductory verse of Vidagdha Madhava? So that we all can hear, so that I can hear and ensure ensure your work, that whatever you are writing, because Mahaprabhu himself, you know, he told Ramananda Rai and Rupa and Swarup Damodar to come and test the works of Rupa Goswami. But in turn, he was testing both of them because he wants to praise Rupa Goswami in front of Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar Goswami. So Mahaprabhu was also present in the assembly. So Mahaprabhu and all the other associates, actually they were sitting on a raised platform. It has also been described in the previous verses that they were sitting, and then they requested Rupa Goswami and Haridas Thakur also to come and join us on sitting on the raised platform. But out of humility, Rupa Goswami and Haridas Thakur said, no, they'll sit down, and they were sitting. So this is the setting that everybody is sitting on a raised platform. Mahaprabhu is sitting right in the front, and Rupa Goswami and Haridas Thakur, they're sitting down. And then Ramananda Rai told Rupa Goswami that, can you recite that introductory verse of your first nataka, that is Vidagdha Madhava, that you wrote? And again, Rupa Goswami was feeling so shy. And then Mahaprabhu, he said, who was present right there in the assembly, he said, yes, yes, Rupa, why don't you please go ahead, do the needful, go and recite that introductory verse that you have written. Even I want to hear that verse. So here the point is that if somebody instructs us to do something, we should not think, oh, wow, this is the opportunity. Now I can show the world, you know, what I'm doing it. But rather we should be humble and, you know, wait for the orders of a spiritual master, because he is the one who is going to lead us onto the right path. So Rupa Goswami, you know, though he was instructed by Ramananda Rai, but still in the heart of his heart, he was thinking that how can I do it without getting the permission from Mahaprabhu? And feeling Rupa Goswami's heart, Mahaprabhu said, oh yes, Rupa, please go ahead. I give you all my permission. Go ahead and recite this introductory verse. And then we all want to see that verse. So what is that verse? We'll see in a little bit time. But here I just want to bring it to a point that why Ramanand Rai, he told Rupa Goswami to recite his introductory verse. So any nataka or any drama which has to be written, it should have a few elements. It's not that haphazardly you can write whatever comes in one's mind. Rather, it should have a proper sequence of things. It should have proper key points. It should have proper elements so that you know, it gives a good experience to whosoever hears or see that drama, that nataka, who reads that. So there should be a proper sequence. So example that as soon as one writes a drama, there should be an introductory verse, which is also called an invocation prayer or a Mangalacharan, right? So there should be an introductory verse in the start. And then further, there should be a verse that glorifies one Ishtadev, one's worshipable deity. Then it should, then on any nataka that one writes, it should be based on some historical event, you know, some historical story should be there. And then all the characters in the drama should be introduced. And then there should be a dramatic entrance of the hero or heroine, if it is based on a heroine. So the main actor, there should be a dramatic, you know, entrance of that main character. And then there should be also a hero who wants to achieve something. And then hero must also have some kind of obstacles in the path. And then some disappointments. And then there should be a proper intermixing of some kind of bhava, some emotions, so and so forth. So all these things will be coming in the future verses, because Ramananda Rai is going to test Rupa Goswami for each and every element of the nataka. So he, because who is, after all, Ramananda Rai? He's an expert dramatist. He knows the minutest details of writing any drama. And so, you know, he wants to really see that how Rupa Goswami is going to present his drama. So, you know, he requested the first thing, that please recite the introductory verse of your drama. So here, I like to share my screen so that you all can see that. Okay. Somehow I'm not able to.
Mataji, what you need to do is put your file open your file, whatever it could be. It could be a Word document or a PPT file. First you keep it, and you do screen share, it will come.
That's what I am. I made a presentation, kind of. But somehow I'm not able to. Okay. So maybe you all can...
You want to try once more, Mataji?
Oh, one more, just once more, just 1 minute. I don't want to. Okay. Okay, so now can you all able to see?
Yes.
Okay, good. So this is the verse that was as the introductory verse that was being recited by Srila Rupa Goswami. So when Mahaprabhu ordered, So somehow Rupa Goswami agreed, and then he recited this verse. So now I hope you all can able to see. This is actually text number 128. You can also open in your book, Ante Lila, verse number 128. Sudhanam Chandrinam api madhuri monmada damani dadhana radhadi pranaya ghana sharira surabhitam samantat santapokkama vishama samsara sharani pranitam te trishnam harato hari lila shikharani. So let's see the last line, hari lila shikharani. So since this verse is an introductory verse of the drama Vidagdha Madhava, which describes Krishna's pastimes, so Rupa Goswami is quoting Hari Leela. Leela means pastimes, and Shikharani. These pastimes of Sri Krishna, they are like Shikharani. So what is Shikharani? We all have know the recipe, because in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, when Preeti Vilasini Mataji was giving the class, she actually told the recipe of Shikharani, because this is the same Shikharani when Gop Kumara, he went to Goloka Vrindavan. He got to eat this Shikharani, right? So this is the Shikharani, which is a sweet preparation that is made up of yogurt and sugar candy. So actually, I'll just quote right from the purport of Brihad Bhagavatamrita, where it says that to yogurt is added a cinnamon, a rock sugar, a ground black pepper, and a green cardamom powder, as well as honey and ghee. And then the mixture is kept for some time in a vessel packed in ice. So this is how Shikharani is made. But as per Ayurveda, it has also been mentioned that there is some camphor also which is being added. So just remember this word camphor. Not to, for today, but in future verses, I'll just give you a hint that Mahaprabhu, you know, Rupa Goswami, he was... Ramanandrai, he was telling Rupa Goswami that please go on reciting this, and then finally the whole Vidagdha Madhava, you know, all the elements he completed, and then he said, oh, go on and tell about Lalita Madhava also. And then Lalita Madhava, he asked for the introductory verse and for his Ishtadev, and then, you know, Mahaprabhu said, hey, what are you doing? You are adding poison in your so-called Shikharani, you are adding a poison to it. And Ramananda said, no, you are not adding poison, rather you are adding camphor to it to enhance the taste of Shikharani. So therefore, you know, in this Shikharani, sometimes camphor is also added. So what happens now? So now he's saying that this is what Shikharani is. So it's a sweet preparation that is made up of yogurt and sugar candy. Now what happens when one hears such sweet pastimes? So let's see the third line. Samantat santat udgama vishame samsara sharani. So samantat means everywhere. Saman roop se, like equality wise. So samantat means everywhere there is santap, there are miseries, all every time there is a miserable condition. Udgama, they are generating themselves in this material world. Nobody is asking for any miseries, but somehow these miseries are generating, this santap, these miseries are generating everywhere, right? And then vishama, and then this miseries are very dangerous. Then next word is samarna sarani, that they are udgama, they are generating because of samsara sarani. Samsara means this material world, right? So those who take shelter, sharani, those who take shelter of this samsara, those who take shelter of this material existence, then what happens? Then we'll see the last line. So, one who takes actually the shelter of this samsara, this material existence, definitely all these material conditions will generate. And then let's see the last line. Pranitam te trishnam, trishnam. So pranitam is like it's been created. What is created? Trishna, our desires are created. So whosoever takes shelter of this material existence, then from everywhere, And anywhere these miseries, these so-called miseries, which are present everywhere, the so-called material conditions, and which are also very dangerous. What are they creating? They are creating, they are generating some unwanted desires in the hearts of that living entities. But then he says, Harautu Leela, Hari Leela Shikharani. Those who hear your pastimes, O Krishna, O my Lord, Haratu, you just takes away, Harana, you just takes away, to take away all such unwanted desires from the heart of such people. And now let's see the first line. Sudhanam Chandrinam Api. Sudha means nectar. And Chandranam means produced by the moon. And api means even. So we all know that there is a nectar that is produced by the moon, which is so sweet, which is madhuri, which is so sweet. Because we all know that the nectar that is found in the fruits and vegetables, it is all because of the moon. So it's because of the moon's influence only that the vegetables, they become delicious. Because without the moonshine, the vegetable can neither grow, nor they can have any taste in them. Like in Bhagavad Gita also, Krishna says that it's only because of the moon that all the vegetables, all the fruits, all the vegetation, you know, they have some nectar in them. So moon is also known as Rasatmakaha, one who provides juice or all to all kinds of vegetation, to fruits and to the vegetables. So from the Bhagavad Gita verse, we all know, it says that Pushmami Chaudasha Sarva Soma Bhutva Rasatmakaha. Krishna says that I enter into each planet and I become the moon and thereby supply the juice of life to all kinds of vegetables. So moon is known as Rasatmakaha, that produces nectar. But here Rupa Goswami is saying that such sweetness that is produced by moon is overpowered by the sweetness of hearing Krishna's katha. Unmada Damini. Unmad means it gets overpowered. Damini means the effulgence. The effulgence, that Damini, that striking nectar, that sweet nectar that is produced by the moon is overpowered by one who hears Krishna's pastimes. So Damini means effulgence, shine, or Srila Prabhupada writes as pride. So Krishna's pastimes are so sweet that they overpower the sweetness that is produced by the moon. How do they overpower? Let's see the next line. The pastimes of Krishna are sweetest because the dhana means distributing. Because such pastimes, when we hear those pastimes, something is distributed. What is distributed? Radhadi pranaya ghana. Ghana means dense. Like in the morning in a Guru Ashtakam, we sing, right? Samsara dava nalalida loka tranaya karunya ghana ghanatvam. So ghana means something very dense, condensed. So here he's saying radhadi, right? Ghana refers to dense. So pranaya means loving affair. A loving affair. Pranaya means concentrated loving affair. Loving affair of whom? Radha Adi. Loving affair of Srimati Radharani. And Adi means etc. Means the loving affair of Srimati Radharani and all other gopis. Sarahi. Sarahi means sar, the essence, the conclusion. Surabhitam. And it creates a good fragrance. So second lines, actually, just the second line, it means that Krishna's pastimes are sweetest, that they overpower the sweetness or the nectar that is produced by the moon. Because the Krishna's pastimes, they have the ability to distribute the sweet fragrance of the concentrated loving affair of Srimati Radharani and the gopis. So that's the meaning that... He writes. So let's read the translation. May the pastimes of Shri Krishna reduce the miseries existing in the material world and nullify all unwanted desires. The pastimes of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are like shikharani, a blend of yogurt and sugar candy, and they overpower the pride of even the nectar that is produced on the moon. For they distribute the sweet fragrance of the concentrated loving affairs of Srimati Radharani and the gopis. So this is the translation. So this is just the introductory verse that Rupa Goswami quoted. So such a sweet introductory verse glorifying the power and the sweetness of hearing Krishna Katha, the pastimes of divine couples. So we should not take it, you know, very lightly. These pastimes are something that can help us to go home back to Godhead. So we should really relish those pastimes. We should envision those pastimes. We should dive deep into those pastimes. Anyway, after hearing this verse, Rai Ramananda, he was very pleased, and he was even struck with wonder. And he says, wow, you have written such a beautiful introductory verse. And even Mahaprabhu was present there. He was ecstatic. He said, what a wonderful verse you have written, Rupa Goswami, describing Krishna's pastimes. But then Ramanandrai said, now, can you please recite the descriptions of the glories of your Ishtadev, your worshipable deity, the second element he is asking of his Nataka. That, okay, now we have heard your introductory verse. Now, can you please describe the glories of your Ishtadev, your worshipable deity? And then Rupa Goswami was so embarrassed because his Ishtadev is none other than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sitting right in front of him. So because he was present in that assembly, he somehow thought that, oh, how can I, you know, he was feeling somewhat embarrassed. But hearing the request of Ramananda Rai, Mahaprabhu said, oh, yes, yes, please continue, Rupa. We want to hear what else is there in your Nataka, in your drama. Why? Because now he knew that the introductory verse itself is glorifying Krishna's pastime. So definitely, you know, his Mangalacharan, his Ishtadev, the verse that he has written about his Ishtadev will be much more wonderful because now he'll be glorifying Krishna. So he said, oh, yes, yes, Rupa, please go ahead. And why are you feeling so embarrassed? You have written such a beautiful verse. So please go ahead and just recite your verse glorifying your worshipable deity. And when Rupa Goswami recited the verse glorifying his worshipable deity, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disapproved it. And he closed his eyes saying, Vishnu, Vishnu, what are you saying, Rupa Goswami? Why have you written this verse? Because this verse was actually the glorification of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because Rupa Goswami's Ishtadev is Mahaprabhu. So the verse was glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu felt so embarrassed, and he said, what have you done, Rupa Goswami? Why have you described me? So this, you know, he said, in my opinion, your verse is just an exaggerated explanation, and hence I disapprove it. But all the devotees who were present there, they were highly appreciating that words. That, you know, no, you are not doing anything wrong. Rather, they appreciated and they felt gratitude towards Rupa Goswami's writing, that you have written such a beautiful verse. They all became ecstatic hearing that verse in glorification of Mahaprabhu. So here, you know, why I said just think of camphor, because this is what the verse is, that the Ishtadev, the verse that is being describing the glorification of Ishtadev, Mahaprabhu was thinking that he'll glorify Krishna, but Rupa Goswami is glorifying Mahaprabhu. And even in Lalita Madhava, the introductory verse will be the same verse, like not the same, but of course in the glorification of Mahaprabhu. And then, you know, after hearing that verse of introductory verse of Lalita Madhava, Mahaprabhu said, hey, you have added poison. You have added alkali to your sweet shikharani that you have made. And then all the devotees will say, no. You have not added any kind of alkali. You have not added any kind of poison. Rather, you have added camphor to that shikharani, which is enhancing the taste of shikharani. So that we'll see in future verses. But here the point I was trying to make, that the shikharni, the taste is enhanced when camphor is added, edible camphor, of course. So they all became ecstatic. And then Rupa, they all requested that please, please, please go ahead and recite your another verse that you have written. And then this is Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila 1.132. अनार्पितं चरिं चिरात् करुणयावतीर्णः कलौ समर्पयितुमुन्नतोज्ज्वलारसां स्वभक्तिश्रियम् हरिपुरत सुन्दर द्वैति कदम्ब सन्दीपिताः सदा हृदय कन्दरे स्फुरतु वा सच्चिनन्दना. So this is the verse that Rupa Goswami, he wrote. And then we'll take a little pause, because we'll take a spend time in understanding that what this beautiful verse is about. So I'll just see the time. It's 10:35, so we can definitely go through. So this verse is also actually borrowed by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami as a Mangalacharan in his book Chaitanya Charitamrita. We saw this verse has also appeared in the first chapter of Adi Leela as the fourth verse. So this is such an important verse that Rupa Goswami wrote in glorification of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So let's see word by word of this verse and understand, because it is very important verse in our Gaudiya Sampradaya, because this is the verse that gives the identity of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in this verse, hope you are able to see on the screen. So let's see the last word, Sachi Nandanaha. So why Rupa Goswami,
Mataji, can only see your book, Mataji, through the shloka. I didn't see the shloka, maybe others can see.
You cannot see the shloka?
We can see only your notes, Mataji.
And now we can see, Mataji.
You can see?
Yes, Mataji, just not me. Yes.
Okay. Now what? Now you can see or not?
Yes, Mataji, yes.
You can see the shloka, right?
No, now we see the notes. Go back to the shloka. Okay. The shloka, yeah.
Okay, so just 1 minute.
Mataji, I think you're sharing your entire desktop. That's why we can see everything you're opening.
That's fine. Yeah, but now I just want you to focus on the shloka. So previously also you were not able to see the shloka?
We could see. So you were toggling between the two, right? So whenever you're toggling, we are seeing the other parts also. Like suppose...
Okay.
Also, we are able to be like that.
That's fine. So,
yeah,
let's
do
once again.
Because you're sharing the desktop.
Okay. So, now what all you can see?
Now I can see the PowerPoint verse.
And now also you can see the PowerPoint verse?
Yes. We can see.
Yeah, Mataji, we can see the shloka.
Okay. I want you to see the shloka.
Okay.
Okay. So, let's see the last... what do you say? The word. Can you see Sachi Nandana, right? So why not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why not Gauranga? Why not Nimai? Why not Vishambhara? Why not any other name of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why he only wrote about Sachi Nandana? So there we'll understand that Sachi Nandana, actually Krishna's names, they are of two types. One is the primary name and one is the secondary name. So the primary names are known as Mukhya Naam and the secondary name is known as Gaun Naam. Gaun Naam, which is related to the connection of this world. And primary name is the connection with the spiritual world. Like for example, We say the word Jagdish, we say the word Janardana, we say the word Bhagavan, Paramatma. These are all the secondary names because they are related to this material world. Or Deenabandhu, Deenadayal, these are all Krishna's name, right? But these are known as the secondary names. Whereas the primary names have the connection with the spiritual associates of the Lord. Now, for example, we say Devaki Nandan, we say Yashoda Nandan, we say Nandanandan, Arjuna Sakha, Vrindavan Chandra. All these names are the primary names because these names have some connection with the associates or with the abode of the Supreme Lord. So actually, both the names are equally potent. We should not think about the potency of the names because both the primary names or the secondary names, they are equally potent. But reciting Krishna's primary names attracts Krishna's attention much more. So he attracts Krishna's attention very easily. So therefore, because primary names reminds the Lord of his devotees. It's not that Lord ever forgets his devotees, but when we say Yashoda Nandan, so Krishna is immediately reminded of Mother Yashoda and he becomes ecstatic and he immediately, you know, is ready to fulfill all the desires. So this is what it is that, you know, the primary name helps Krishna to get reminded of his devotees. And therefore, the primary names are much more important and we should try to call out Krishna with his primary names. Though, as I said, that both the names are equally potent. It's not that if you'll say Jagdish or if you'll say Bhagavan, Krishna will not appear. But it's that, you know, Krishna feels little more attention when, you know, he gets more attention when we call out with his primary names. So like in Mangalacharan also, you know, we sing, Hey Krishna, Karuna Sindhu, Deena Bandhu, Jagat Pate. So all these are secondary names. Karuna Sindhu, Deena Bandhu, Jagat Pate. But then Gopesha, this is the primary name. Gopesha, you are the Lord of all the Gopas. Gopika Kanta. And then Radha Kanta Namastute. So these are all the primary names. This is the first reason he said that why I wrote Sachi Nandana. And the second reason that is being given is that Rupa Goswami uses the word Sachi Nandana because he wants to highlight, he wants to very merciful nature of Mother Sachi. Because Mother Sachi, she was very polite, she was very gentle, and she never ever chastised Nimai. Whereas if we see Yashoda Maharani, Mother Yashoda, she used to chastise Krishna, not only through his words, but also through a stick. We know the Damodar pastime. So it's not that Mother Yashoda was not gentle, not pure, or not sweet, but it's the Mother Sachi's beauty or her opulence has been highlighted that, you know, she was very polite and she was very gentle and as mother, as son. So just, you know, oh Gauranga, since you are the son of Mother Sachi, so you have developed all your qualities of your mother. And so you are also very merciful and magnanimous. So we know that those who are not ready to chant, and those who are not ready to take Krishna's name, Mahaprabhu begged them, can you please chant? Can you please chant Krishna's name? And he is so freely distributing the love of Godhead without even considering any offenses. He is simply giving out the love of Godhead. Gaur naam, gaur dham, gaur rupa gun, aparade nahi mane tare re nipun. So gaur naam and gaur dham and gaur rup are such that they don't consider any kind of offenses. Rather, they just tarere nipun, they just elevate you, they just liberate you. So this is what the magnanimous nature of Mahaprabhu is. And then Rupa Goswami used, therefore, you know, Rupa Goswami used the word Sachi Nandana. Now see, let's see the third line in which the word Hari is being used. So who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is described in the third line. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, actually in Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya, in Madhya Leela only he said, not sure Madhya or Adi Leela, but he said, he gave the definition He said, Hari Shabd Nana Arthe Dui Mukhyatam Sarva Amangal Hare Prema Diye Hare Man. So this is the definition he is giving of Hari. So who is Hari? One who steals, right? So Rupa, so Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami saying, Hari Shabd Nana Arthe. There are many names, very meanings of this word Hari. But Dui Mukhyatam, there are two primary meanings. And what is that? Sarva Amangal Hare. It takes away all kind of inauspiciousness. Prema Diye Hariman. And also bestows prema and he takes away one's heart. And so Krishna, we all know, he was a thief, right? But he was not the thief of this world, but he was a transcendental thief of the spiritual world. And what is the pramana for that? Bilwa Mangal Thakur writes, Vraje prasidam navanita chauram gopanganam chadukula chauram aneka janma chita papa chauram chauragraganyam purusham namami. So he's saying that you are Vraje prasidam navanita. Navanita is butter. You are stealing the butter and you are also stealing the clothes of all the gopis. And not only that, aneka janmarjita papa chauram. I have collected aneka janma from past immemorable lifetimes. I have been collecting all these papa, arjita. I have been collecting, accumulating all this papa. And just in a fraction of a second, you came and you steal away everything. You steal away all the reactions to our sinful actions. So you steal away everything. So chaura agraganyam, you are the first class. Agra means first class. You are the agraganyam. You are the first class thief. And therefore, purusham namami, I bow down to you. So this is the word Hari. But here, there is another meaning of Hari that is being depicted. And that's the other meaning is lion. So Hari also means lion. Like we say, Narahari. Nara Hari, na manusha na mrignam. So he is Narsingadev, who appeared as Nara Hari, half man, half lion. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in his Adi Leela, he gives these five reasons why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is compared to a lion. The first reason, I don't want to go with the verse because it will take a lot of time, but if somebody wants, I can give you the reference. It's in Adi Leela.
Elaborate if you can.
No, I'll elaborate, but I'm saying if anybody needs the verse, I can give
it.
Okay,
sure. Yeah.
Right? So what I mean to say that this is not, that I have made up or concocted or have just heard, but this is right from Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami's book, from this Chaitanya Charitamrita and from the purports of Prabhupada. So it is right from there. So where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is compared to a lion. The first reason that Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami gives is that his complexion is golden. So we all know that the complexion of lion is so golden and therefore he's been referred to as Hari, as lion. The second, he gives that his hairs are on his shoulders. So we all know that lion's hairs are always on his shoulders. So therefore, before taking sannyas, Mahaprabhu's hair were such that they were covering Mahaprabhu's shoulders. They were so long. It's all before taking sannyas. Then just like as a lion, Mahaprabhu has a broad chest and a thin waist. Just like lion. And then this is about the verse, but in one of the summary of that Adi Leela, I tell you the chapter. In that summary, he wrote that actually Mahaprabhu, when he was born, there was a constellation which is known as Leo. So that is also because of that, born in that Leo constellation, Mahaprabhu is also referred to as lion, as Hari. And then the last and the final and the important reason is that Prabhupada gives in the purport of text number 132, he gives the reason why he's known as lion, that just like when lion roars, what happens? All the small animals and all, even the elephants, they just flee away because hearing the roaring of the lion, hearing the roaring of that sound of that lion. So similarly, when Mahaprabhu, who is sitting in the heart of a pure devotee, when he call out Hari Bol, when he chants the name of Krishna, when Mahaprabhu roars, then, you know, the names of Krishna, then all the anarthas that is present in the heart in the form of an elephant, they all flee away. They all flee away in fear. So that's why, you know, he's also known as Hari. So this is the, we discussed about Sachinandana, that is the last word of the last line. And then the third line, we took third line and we discussed the first word, Hari. The next word is Purata. Purata means gold. So, and then it comes, then the next word, yeah, Purata means, yeah. And then comes Sundara. Sundara means very beautiful. And Duiti, Duiti means complexion. Means complexion. What kind of complexion? Kadamba Sandipitaha. So means shining, shining like a molten gold. So why? Because Mahaprabhu's complexion is molten gold. Why it is molten gold? Because he has taken the complexion of Srimati Radharani. So we know that when the gold is heated, so the gold itself is so illuminated. But when we heat the gold, when the gold is in this molten form, it becomes much more illuminated and much more shining. So because of the heat, because of the heat that is given, when the gold is exposed to that heat, the illumination, the brightness, the effulgence, the shine of that gold, it enhanced. So similarly, the color of Mahaprabhu's is like a molten glow gold. Why? Because even Mahaprabhu was exposed to the heat. He was exposed to the heat of separation from Krishna, from inside. You know, he was in the mood of Srimati Radharani. And he was every time he was feeling that kind of separation from Krishna. So he was exposed that to that heat of separation. And the second, there was a heat of doing Sankirtan. Every day Mahaprabhu used to recite Krishna's names and he used to do Sankirtan. So he was in the heat of doing Sankirtan from outside. Externally, there was a heat of Sankirtan and internally, there was the heat of separation from Srimati Radharani. So when such gold is exposed to the heat, it becomes molten and it becomes more effulgence and it becomes more illuminated. So that's the meaning of Hari Purata Sundara Duiti Kadamba Sandipitaha. Now we'll see here that one name of Hari and then five names of Radharani. Why? Because Purata Sundara Duiti Kadamba Sandipita. These are the five names that glorify the complexion of Srimati Radharani. So why? Because Krishna is always in depth with Srimati Radharani. And so even in this verse, Rupa Goswami is saying that Mahaprabhu is, he is, his complexion is all because of Srimati Radharani. So even he is in depth even in the verse. So because Mahaprabhu, he left his flute, he left her all his ornaments, he left his three, Krishna basically left his threefold bending form, his color, his peacock feather, his pitambar dhoti, and even his hair. So he gave everything and he accepted kamandalu, danda. He accepted sannyas. He accepted saffron robes. He gave up his hair. He gave up his flute. He gave up everything. And as Mahaprabhu, he accepted sannyas and he walks around throughout the world spreading the glories of Srimati Radharani. Now, what he wants to give to this world, why he came, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and what he really wants to give to this world. Now see, let's see the second line. Samarpayitum. Arpitum. Arpitum means to give. Samarpitum means completely. Sam refers to completeness. So something to give completely. What? Unmata ujjvala rasam. Unmata means top class, elevated. Right, unmata. Ujjvala means effulgent. And rasa means mellow. So he came to this world completely to give the top class, highest rasa, which is so effulgent, which is ujjvala, which is ujjvala rasa. And what is that rasa? Madhurya rasa. Madhurya rasa is also known as ujjvala rasa. because it is the highest, it is the top class, it is the most effulgent. And what is that Madhurya Rasa? The conjugal mellow of divine couple, which is actually not approachable even by the great yogis, by the great saints. It's not available, it's not approachable. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is distributing that pure highest love of Madhurya and freely to everyone, without even considering one's qualification, without even considering one's eligibility. But he's simply distributing that highest love, that Ujjvala Rasa, to everybody. So one who seeks actually pleasure in the highest rasa, he is known in the Madhurya Rasa, is what Mahaprabhu's name is. Therefore, Mahaprabhu's another name is Ujjvala Rasa Nanda, one who seeks pleasure in the highest rasa, in the Ujjvala Rasa, in the Madhurya Rasa, who seeks pleasure in that rasa. And here Mahaprabhu is coming to give to everybody without even considering whether that person is eligible or it's qualified or not qualified. Like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in the 7th chapter of Adi Lila, he says, patra apatra vichara nahi, nahi sthana asthana. He never sees whether the person is qualified, is eligible or not, or whether person belongs to this place or not. No. Ye yaha paya tare kare premadhana. Wherever, whomever he meets, he just gives the Krishna prem. He just gives the love of Godhead so freely. And then the next word comes, swabhakti shriyam. Swa means one's own, self. So he is giving his own bhakti. He is distributing his own bhakti. Why? Because he has come in the mood, taking the mood of Srimati Radharani. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna nahi anya. Krishna Purna Shakti, Radha Purna Shakti Man. Dui Vastu Bhed Nahi, Shastra Rapraman. There is no difference between Radharani and Krishna. One is Shakti, one is Shakti Man. But here, this Shakti Man has taken the mood of Shakti and has appeared in this world. And he is giving his own bhakti, swa bhakti. He is giving his own bhakti here. So, Mahaprabhu has come in the mood of Radharani to give his own bhakti. Shriya means treasure. So he is basically opening his treasure house of that highest Madhurya, that highest Ujjvala Rasa. He is giving that. Just like Prabhupada always gives this example, that if there is some rich person who is literally drunk, who is intoxicated because of that intoxication that he has taken and who has completely lost his senses, what he will do? He'll simply freely reveal, you know, he'll, like a mad person, he'll walk on the roads, he'll freely give away all his passwords, all his bank account details, and, you know, he'll open up his wallet. He'll do any kind of things. In this regard, I'll just share you one thing. You know, once we went to book distribution, it was an event. And we were distributing those small books, you know, Chant and Be Happy, Yoga, The Perfection, and, you know, The Higher Taste. Those small books. And we had make a packet kind of thing. And we were giving those packets. So it was an event. I don't remember exactly which event it was. Some Patrick's Day or... No, not Patrick's Day. But it was some kind of event. I don't remember. But people were literally drunk. But some people were giving $1 or $2. And one drunkard, you know, he was totally drunk. And he came and I was just standing and the kirtan was also going on because it was a Harinam cum book distribution together. So that person came to me and it was very hard for me to explain anything about that book because it was such a foul smell coming from his mouth. But somehow, you know, I managed to speak something. I'm pretty sure he has not even understood a single word what I said. But, you know, he took that book and he immediately gave me $50 from his wallet. So I said, wow, this is awesome. He covered the cost of all other packets that we have distributed. So this is how drunkards are. They completely lose their senses. And, you know, they can give, maybe at home when he must have gone, he must have realized what he has done. So just a few books, he gave $50. So that's how it is. Right, so same way here, our dear most intoxicated madman, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is completely intoxicated in Radha Bhav. He is completely intoxicated in Radha Prem. And he has opened his treasure house very freely so that everyone can come and plunder him. So to that, with, you know, he's doing it. So we should really take advantage of it. The bottom line is that yes, when Mahaprabhu has come, so please, please, we should really take advantage of it. We should really take advantage of this intoxicated, this transcendental intoxicated madman person who is literally allowing everyone to plunder his treasure house. So, and of course, our dear Srila Prabhupada, who has also come to assist in this plundering. So we should all, you know, assist Prabhupada. Anyway, so when Mahaprabhu appeared, so let's see the first line, last part. Karunaya avatirna kalau. Karunaya, very mercifully, very magnanimously he came. Avatirna, he has manifested, he has appeared kalau in the dark age of Kali Yuga. So very mercifully Mahaprabhu has appeared in this dark age of Kali. If Kali Yuga, just to bestow this highest rasa, this highest madhurya rasa, this ujvala rasa to everyone. And that highest love, what is that highest love? Let's see the first part of the first line. Anarpitam charim chirat. Anarpitam means which has, arpita means which has been given before. Arpita means to bestow, which has been given before. Anarpita means which has never been given before. Chiram Chirat means for a very, very long time, this Mahaprabhu has come, because we know that Mahaprabhu comes only in once, in one day of Brahma. Okay, it's already 12. Just give me 5-10 minutes more and I'll wrap up. So Mahaprabhu, he comes only in once in one day of Brahma. So, and it's only Mahaprabhu who basically gives this love of Godhead. So therefore he sings Chiram Chirat. For a very, very long time, this has not been given, but now Mahaprabhu has appeared and he is giving this love of Godhead. So Rupa Goswami is saying that Mahaprabhu, who is Sachinandana, who is taking the complexion and mood of Srimati Radharani, who have very mercifully manifested, have appeared in this dark age of Kali Yuga to bestow completely what the highest rasa of that spiritual world, which is Madhurya rasa, to whom? To everyone, everywhere and to everyone, without even considering one's prerequisites, you know, of that receiver. Because the path of devotion is extremely glorious, that even the Lord himself wants to be a devotee and taste that devotion. And then let's see just the last line. Now he's last line, Rupa Goswami is giving a blessing. He's giving a benediction. He's saying, Sada Hridaya Kandare Spurato. Sada means always, all time. Hridaya Kandare. Kandare means cave. Hridaya means heart. So Spurato means manifest. So Rupa Goswami is saying that this Lord Sachinandana, may he manifest in the caves of our hearts. Whose hearts? That is important. The second last word before Sachinandana, there's the word Vah. So Vah is very important. Vah shows the selfless nature of Rupa Goswami. He's saying that, he's not saying that in my heart, but he's saying your. Vah means your. So may that Lord, may that Sachinandana manifest in the caves of your heart. Whose heart? One who reads it. One who recites this verse. To that living entity's heart, may that Supreme Lord, may that Sachinandana, may, you know, he may manifest in that heart. So Rupa Goswami, so selflessly, he's giving benediction to everyone by composing this verse. And including that verse as the introductory verse of his Vidagdha Madhava Nataka. So remember that this is actually the verse which was told by Ramananda Rai, that please recite your verse in which you have glorified your Ishtadev. And then Rupa Goswami, he said this verse, Anarpitam Charim Chirat. And then he said this verse, he composed this verse, and he introduced that verse as a glorification of his Ishtadev, his Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his Vidagdha Madhava Nataka. So let's read the translation now. May the Supreme Lord, who is known as the son of Srimati Sachi Devi, be transcendently situated in the innermost core of your heart, resplendent with the radiance of molten gold. He has descended in the age of Kali by his causeless mercy to bestow what no incarnation has ever bestowed, ever offered before, the most elevated conjugal mellow of devotional service, the mellow of conjugal love. So this is what being told. So we'll take a pause here and we'll stop here. And then we'll continue next, seeing what next Rupa Goswami wants to offer. And what next Rupa Goswami wants to offer. So thank you all so much for patiently listening. And please excuse me, I took 15 or 20 minutes extra. But I just want to cover this verse because this is very, very important verse. So thank you all so much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Even if you had gone 15 more minutes, we wouldn't have minded at all. It was so wonderful. It was like tasting shikharini with camphor. Wonderful class, as always. Very, very nice and very pleasing to the heart. I feel very, very happy when we hear such beautiful descriptions. Both the verses were dealt with so much detail, and it was so beautiful to hear. Very pleasing. Mataji, I had, as you were talking about the primary names and the secondary names of Sri Krishna, and you were also mentioning that the primary names generally relate to the associates, meaning his relation with associates. So I was just wondering, so Krishna itself is a primary name or a secondary name? Because you were also talking Krishbhu Vachika Shabda, which is mainly an attractor. So how would you classify the name Krishna?
Krishna is the primary name. Krishna is the primary name. Krishna. Go ahead.
Now, since the definition was also related to in relationship with his dear devotee, so how would we classify Krishna as a primary name in relationship with any devotee?
Krishna, like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he mentions Krishi Bhu Vachaka Shabdo. So the word Krish is the attractive feature of the Lord himself. So it has nothing related to his devotees. It has nothing related to this material world. It is related to himself. So that is why this word Krish and Na refers to the Ananda that he himself is feeling. So Krishna is definitely the primary name of the Lord. Because it deals with he himself.
It is with he himself. Very nice. Yes. Very nice analysis. Yeah. Love the class, especially the description of these two verses. You took us there, Mataji, seriously. I can imagine how Rupa Goswami was feeling and how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was literally feeling, like, you know, closing his ears. It's very beautiful. Yeah. And the mood of Sri Rupa Goswami goes a long way, meaning for every one of us to always remember. It's very nice. You really brought out the pastime. Thank you very much for all the efforts. This is a lot of effort that you're putting. Thank you so much. And this is really needed for us. Thank you very, very much. Very grateful.
Hare. Thank you so much, Preeti Vilasanaji. Thank you for always empowering me through your instructions. So thank you all so much.
Hare Krishna Mataji, thank you so much.
Krishna, I could see Janavi. Where is she now?
She was taking a phone and I asked her to stop to Mataji. Don't know. She's angry now.
I was able to see.
Yeah, Mataji, thank you so much. Actually, what Preeti Vilasini Mataji mentioned, it's really needed this your class for us. Especially, Mataji, when we miss some of the slokas, you just summarize all things, whatever is before sloka also, and you explain so nicely. It's very helpful for me, Mataji. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami mentioned this sloka in the beginning. It is, he got from this Dhamma?
Yes, he borrowed from the Rupa Goswami's works with Atmadeva.
Okay, yeah.
He borrowed from him because, just imagine, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is writing this Chaitanya Charitamrita when he was 95 years old. He was a pretty old man. And it was very, very difficult for him to write Chaitanya Charitamrita. But all the devotees somehow, you know, they pressurized him that you should write Chaitanya Charitamrita. And also Rupa Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami was little hesitant because Chaitanya Mangal, Chaitanya Bhagavat, they were already present there. So he was quite hesitant. But since all the devotees, you know, they requested, so he accepted their request. But at the same time, taking a humble position, he went to Madan Mohan temple when the garland fell, and then he thought, okay, this is the desire of Madan Mohan that I should write. And so, you know, he's taking the blessings of Rupa Goswami, of Mahaprabhu, Panchatattva, of everybody, even Vrindavan Das Thakur, Lochan Das Thakur. He's taking the blessings of everybody, and therefore then he starts writing this Chaitanya Charitamrita. So this was the verse which was composed by Rupa Goswami, and he introduced it in his Vidagdha Madhava Nataka, and Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami basically borrowed that verse so that he can get the blessings of Rupa Goswami also. That was his mood.
Thank you, Matiji. And Matiji, that two sloka, yes, what Rupa Goswami explained about the name of the Krishna, that two word is so powerful. Is it he got from the reference, or he composed that both verses, you know, this drama whole he composed, or he got some of the verses?
No, he composed the whole drama, but that word, that Krishna Bhu Vachako Shabdo, that is actually by Shankaracharya, I think so, I'm not sure. But that is introduced by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in his Adi Leela.
Comes in the definition, meaning like how the root word is taken out, Krishi.
Yes, Krishi Bhu Vachako Shabda. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Madhavi, for your hard work, Madhavi. It's really, really helpful. Otherwise, you know, you are just doing homework for us, Madhavi. Thank you so much.
Oh, I really like that statement she made. That's so true. You're just doing homework for us. Well put, Mataji.
I'm happy to do that homework, because that is so purifying even for me. Now you have seen my notes also, how the way I'm scribbling everything.
Yeah, so much of hardworking, Mataji. You could see your all the points, notes, everything. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Anjana Gopika Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much for your efforts you put and your wonderful class, Mataji. It's actually a mercy on us. And when the part you explained about Hari, the lion, and the reason why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was said as lion. Actually, in Madhya Leela, there's a 7.95. There's a sloka, it says Matta Simha. So starts with Matta Simha, where they said that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going to South India for the tour, he was almost like a mad lion, chanting and leading the kirtanas. Actually, there's a part lion, but I not know why he has been said as lion.
So why he has said in lion, that is in Adi Leela, that all these references are being given by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. But why he is known as lion? I'll just search for that and I'll let you know.
Okay,
Mataji. In the meantime, if you have any other question, just let me know.
Yes, Mataji. And when you give the explanation, I can understand why he has been said as Hari. That means Hari really compares to lion, the meaning. And my question is, Mataji, it's been when Rupa Goswami was explaining or telling the verse about this Ishta Deva, he said Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually was not happy with it. He was not allowed.
Internally, he was happy. Externally, he was showing that, you know, why you are doing this. Externally, it was just an external composure. But inside, internally, Mahaprabhu was very happy.
Okay.
Actually, he writes, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, in the future verses, you'll come to know that Mahaprabhu was internally very, very happy. But externally, he was angry. He was showing his anger.
Okay. Nice, Mataji. And also they say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a hidden avatar.
He's a hidden avatar, yes.
All the other previous avatars, they were so much exposed to, like everyone knows about them, and there were like more epics about them, so everybody can understand. Even while they were doing the avatar, everybody was aware of them. But why is the reason that this avatar was particularly hidden? like he was
not ready because this was a confidential avatar, and because Mahaprabhu came just to satisfy his personal desires. It was all the other avataras were, you know, like paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya chatushtutam dharma sansthapanarthaya. No, they were all following this such kind of rules. But this was the incarnation where Krishna came just to satisfy his hidden desire. Though externally we know that, you know, he came on the cry and the loud roar of Advaita Acharya. External reasons are there. But, you know, because of his internal reasons, he wants to relish the mood of Srimati Radharani. And also he wants to pay the debt to Srimati Radharani because he's in a great debt at that time. So, you know, so this avatar is a channa avatar, is a hidden incarnation. But he is Krishna himself. We have known so many, you know, verses where it says that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is non-different from Krishna. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahi, and he is the combined incarnation of Srimati Radharani and Shri Krishna.
That makes more sense, Mataji. So he was coming to satisfy his hidden desire. But when they say when all the avatars came to demolish the demons, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu avatar is like demolishing the demons within us. He's demolishing so much demons from within us. So it's very nice. Thank you so much, Mataji.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, Lakshmi Mataji. So in the purport of, so this I found the reference. It's Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Leela chapter entitled is the external reasons of Lord Chaitanya's appearance. And this is verse number 30, where he gives different reasons. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is giving the various reasons that how he is compared to a lion. And then in the chapter 3 on the summary part, he gives that how he appears in a Leo constellation. So that is also he's known as Lion.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hare.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, why you are here?
Nice class, Mataji. Really nice to hear.
And now this is the same embarrassment I'm feeling. Oh, Krishna, if I would have known that you are here, I would have never even bothered to speak or utter a single word. Please.
Beautiful class, Mataji. Really nice to hear all these wonderful realizations. And thank you so much for speaking them out to the devotees, Mataji. Really, really beautifully spoken. Thank you so much, Mataji.
Please accept my humble obeisances, Prabhu. And please, please, please take out some kind of correction, you know, if you feel like, please, Prabhu.
No, it was beautiful, Mataji. It was all perfect. But thank you so much for speaking so nicely, Mataji, and inspiring the devotees. You're really doing a wonderful service, Mataji. Thank you so much.
So I would just like to make one comment, you know, this word, anarpitam charim chirat, I was not able to find that how to sing this, but somehow when I YouTube it, I got that, you know, Haripashat Prabhu has literally sung this verse in his melodious voice, and there is a recording in YouTube. So if you all can please refer to that recording and memorize this verse, that's what I did. And Prabhu mentioned that this verse is in Prithvi meter because he knows all the meters, and whenever I have a problem, I always refer to him. So thank you so much, Prabhuji. Thank you. It was a great surprise.
Hare Krishna, Ji Kirti Dasan Pidasi. Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. When you explain about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is given a Hari Naam Sankirtan, not seeing the qualification, and Hari Bol, Hari Bol. When they take a sannyas and Saktiman together, and how nicely you explain that you are doing a book distribution seva, and that person is totally intoxicated, and you are intoxicated by the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Shri Nityananda mercy. So two intoxicated people together, and you give the mercy of that person. I feel that because we are doing a 5 points every Saturday seva with Haji Balbhadra Prabhu. Mataji, I have seen that again, people will take a Krishna consciousness and give $100 and try come to temple with a half t-shirt and a half pant, and then they start pant shirt and then tulsi mala and then dhoti kurta.
Mataji, no words to your seva. How nicely you are totally like Priti Vilasini is explaining Leela. We say why she is stop, like we upset like that from last 7-8 every time Mataji, but 8-9 session Mataji, we understand each and every words. Remember, I each and every words evening time I explained with my two daughters sitting outside and my Prabhu. So Mataji, how nicely you are, like you are totally involved, and how much hard work we have seen today's your notes, that how much puts efforts to give us Krishna consciousness, and we are last bench student that not prepare a note. We are cooking time, we are hearing, but today I give a promise that evening time I hear your lecture and prepare a note and send in this group. Koti koti dandavat pranam. Srila Prabhupada, Srila Gurudev ki jai. Sisi Chaurashtakam, you are explaining so nicely. If you are not tired, can you sing whatever you like to sing?
Yes, Prabhupada ji. Thank you. Thank you so much for all your sincerity. And always present in the morning calls, in the mid-morning calls, in the evening calls. It's all because of your sincerity that you are able to relish. So it's just a reflection that you are seeing. It's all yours. So yes, Mataji, will definitely honor, but I don't think so now I'll be able to do it, because now since Harivarsha Prabhu is there, it's impossible for me to take any further comments or any further questions, because in front of him, it's just like showing a lamp to a sun, you know, a dwarf catching a moon. It's impossible now.
But it's night here, Mataji, so there is no sun. You can light all the lamps you want, Mataji.
Krishna, I cannot win from your Shastra, Prabhu. You are amazing.
Please go ahead and please continue the wonderful question and answers, Mataji. I'm also eager to hear.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah, anyone else has any questions?
Better don't ask.
I don't have a question.
Good.
Actually, I had a question, but Priti Mataji already asked about the Krishna name. So thank you so much for explaining that. Thank you for all your efforts and very nice presentation. And your energy and your involvement in Chaitanya Charitamrita is very inspiring. Thank you so much. It definitely gets passed on to others, Mataji. It definitely inspires me a lot. Thank you so much, Mataji.
Yeah, we can see the Damini, right? She was defining Damini.
Krishna. That was the embarrassment when I saw Harivarsha Prabhu.
Take only 1 second, Mataji. Whenever we hear lectures, Krishna Katha or Chaitanya Charitamrita from Senior Vaishnava Mataji, it gives lots of strength to fight the present situation. Like when the patient is there, they are so much frustrated to sit in one room. And Mataji, whatever we explain in the evening time, they hear so sincerely. And I don't know how I can explain them, Mataji. That is your and all the senior Mataji's efforts. Today I have seen how much hard work you all are doing. Koti koti dandavat pranam to your seva.
It's because of our purification, Mataji, because we have to write, otherwise, you know, especially me, I just cannot speak spontaneously. So that's the reason we have to write the notes, at least for myself. Thank you, Vrinda Gopika Mataji, for all your encouraging words. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Kitina Mataji, please explain. Mataji, as all Matajis are saying, I also second it. It was really wonderful class. And Mataji, I have a question. While you are telling Rupa Goswami's drama, how he narrated, how he set the scenes, what are the characters, how he brings the characters, what are the emotions. So Mataji, the present day, the drama, is the same steps are followed, Mataji?
No, Mataji. Yeah, nothing. You can see the dramas is literally a drama. Today's dramas are literally a drama. It doesn't follow any protocols. You know that.
So because I'm not in general, Mataji, because there is a film industry. They have the drama institute also. Does they follow this and they teach to the students the dramas and everything on the basis of this?
No, Mataji, not at all. I don't think so. Because these dramas are literally, they refer to a proper shastra, which is a Nataka shastra.
Yes, Mataji. Yes.
So, I don't think so anybody is referring to all that.
Oh, okay, okay. Because there is like, in this high school also, they my kids have the high school, one credit like a drama also. So, I got a question like, is this the same follow the characters, the mood, the scene setting, the entry, the ending, everything is the same, I thought, Mataji.
Maybe somewhere here and there, but definitely not as the protocol that is being followed by a proper Nataka Shastra.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much for clarifying, Mataji. And another question, Mataji, you're mentioning like a sweet recipe like Shri Karani. Is it like Shrikant Mataji, similar to Shrikant?
Yeah, somewhere it is mentioned that somewhere, some people call Shikarani as Shrikant, but, I referred from Brihad Bhagavatamrita, the proper recipe, when Gopakumara got to taste when he went to Vrindavan.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mataji. And thanks a lot for beautiful singing, Mataji. Very nice and melodious.
It's all glorious to Hari Parshad.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Dhamma Pranam, all the best to Srila Prabhupada. Such a beautiful class, Mataji. Like as last week, you were already in that effulgence of doing it. Like we could see it and this week also. I think until Leela is like it is, you are getting the nectar out of each and every verse in such a beautiful way. And the notes when you shared, when like by mistake it got shared, but then it was really your hard work.
It was mistakenly shared.
I know, but it was like Lord's mercy that we could see your efforts, you know. So then it is really, really awesome. And thank you so much, you know, because after this Antalila, I guess it has so much of nectar and everything comprised that everybody should really, really, really listen to it. Because that just gives away so much of, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, I think when Krishna Dham Prabhu, he started with the Chaitanya Charitamrita for everyone. He just started a group. So we started with the Adilila. And it is like, no, like once I started reading, I just wanted to read. And this camp, after the camp, the Madhalila did not, I could not read that much part. But Antalila, I really did not want to miss at least listening from the beginning. And I guess like this, your classes and everybody is giving classes for the Antalila is really bringing the nectar out. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah. Future verses are really hard. And now, since Hari Parshad Prabhu is present on the call, and I was thinking before also that I'll request Preeti Virasni Mataji that if we can schedule the future verses with Hari Parshad Prabhu, because they are so deep. They're so deep and it's so difficult. Like I was really spellbound when I read those verses last night, and I was thinking it's so difficult for me to explain because you really have to go deep into the ocean if you really want to gather those shells. But otherwise, since we are just floating onto the surface of the ocean, it's very difficult to understand those future verses. So definitely, Preeti Vilasni Mataji, if you can go ahead and request.
Great pleasure.
Best part was, Mataji, like when your class tells that you are already reading the further things and you are making so much of study for it. It's really wonderful, Mataji. So as you're doing the homework for us, what you stated, it is really true. You're doing your homework for us. So thank you, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Dandavat Pranam, Srila Prabhupada.
Krishna, Dandavat Pranam.
Very, very beautiful class, Mataji. Very nice singing, very nice answers. Everything is so good. Nice to see your notes, how much you
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. You are doing so much.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. It's for my purification, Mataji. Purely for my own self.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you.
Yeah, and since you were all discussing about Shikharini, we have Vrinda who has actually made it and offered it and tasted it. the exact recipe of Gopakumar, I mean, who shared in Gopakumar's story. I think she did the chicken and she tasted it. So.
Wow, nice, nice.
Yeah, Mataji had shared it, right? That same day I made it.
Yeah. Hare Krishna, Kirti Dasundari Mataji, Dandavat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, Indu Mataji, Dandavat Pranam.
Wonderful class and so nice to see your notes and how much of preparation goes into it and how we should also study that you actually teach us by example. So really love that, very inspiring. And Mataji, I did have a question. You were talking about camphor and poison, like he was referring to the two things, and Ramananda Raya says, no, it's not like adding poison to it. It's like
alkali. It's Kaviraj Goswami mentions the word alkali.
Okay.
The Prabhupada translates it as alkali. What he said is, the exact word, what he said, that why you are adding. So, Vedanta Madhava, and then goes on to the Lalita Madhava. And then, yeah, so Mahaprabhu was very angry externally, and he said, your exalted poetic descriptions of the mellows of Lord Krishna's pastimes are like an ocean of nectar. But why have you put in a false prayer about me? It is just like a drop of detestable alkali. So here the word is used as shara bindu. Shara. So Hari Parshad Prabhu, shara is like a poison. Can you please comment on that?
Astringent.
Astringent.
Something which has a lemon-like flavor. You know, because if you add lemony substance to nectar, it is immediate rasavas. That's what is being indicated here.
Thank you. So you got it in the mouth. So it's just like putting something lemon in that kheer, in that shikharani.
Okay. So then why did he say that it's like adding camphor? What is camphor's purpose in that? Is there some other meaning?
Camphor enhances the taste. Right? Alkali is something that give distaste to a sweet dish.
Okay, but it has its own distinctive flavor too.
It's a distinct flavor, but it spoils the sweetness.
Camphor has its own distinct flavor.
But camphor, camphor has a distinct flavor, but it enhances the sweetness. So for Mahaprabhu, when he was being glorified in the introductory verses of both the Natakas, Mahaprabhu said, oh, you have added shara, you have added that alkali into that sweet pudding, that shikharni that you prepared. But Ramananda Raya said, no, it is not alkali. It is basically you are adding camphor. Means you are, by glorifying Mahaprabhu, you are adding, you are enhancing the sweet of that shikharni. You are enhancing the sweet of that dish.
Perfect, perfect. Thank you so much, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
So camphor basically enhances, but yes, a person like me doesn't like camphor. So maybe that's why you are saying, but camphor basically enhances the taste.
Thank you so much, Mataji.
Because it just in the next, you know, next verse, Ramananda Rai said, he objected. He said, it is not alkali at all. It is a particle of camphor that he has put into the nectar of his exalted poetic expression. So please go ahead, go on and on. Anior, go ahead. So, you know, in that mood.
Yes, I mean, that is just perfect. I mean, the way they come up with these different analogies to explain how Gauranga Mahaprabhu's, how he's... Sorry, Mataji. No, thank you so much, Mataji.
Thank you so much, Indu Mataji.
Kirtida Sundari Mataji, there is one request from Radhika Kasturi Mataji. She wants you to forward the recording of Hari Parshad Prabhu's recital of the verse to forward.
Okay, you want me to do it here on the chat?
Oh, yeah, she's not here. I can text her. Yeah, she just wants you to share it on the group. Yeah.
So, You just go to YouTube and put Anarpitam Charim Chirat. You can hear now.
Anarpita Charim Chirat Karuna Yavatirna Kalau Samarpayitumunnato Jvalara Samsva Bhakti Shriyam Hari पुरट सुंदर द्युति कदंब संदीपिता सदा हृदय कंदरे स्फुरतु वः शची नंदन
थैंक यू माताजी
ओके सो वी विल स्टॉप हियर एंड वी विल ऑनर वृंदा गोपिका माताजी'स रिक्वेस्ट So, Mataji, on your request, I'll just sing two verses of, since we discussed the word Hari, so we'll sing Chaurashtakam only. And this year is also, we'll be observing Purushottam Mass. And so we, because this is the, you know, the Ashtakam that is normally sing in that Purushottam Mass, every day we sing in this Ashtakam in the Purushottamas. So definitely since this year we will be observing this month, so this Purushottam month, so we can always sing. So I'll just sing two verses and then we'll pause.
Vraje prasidam navnita chauram gopanganam cha tukula chauram अनेक जन्म चित पाप चौरम चौराग्र गण्यम पुरुषम नमामि क्षीराधिकाया चौरम नवंबुदाशाम लकांति चौरम पादाश्रितानां च समस्त चौरम चौराग्र गण्यम पुरुषं नमामि कारागृहे वसा सदा हृदये मध्ये मद्भक्ति पाश दृढबन्धना निश्चलसन् त्वं कृष्ण हे प्रलया कोटि स्वतन्त्रेऽपि सर्वस्व चौरं हृदि नमोचयामि So this last verse is very important. Krishna, he's saying, Oh Krishna, who is the thief of everything, the noose of my devotion remaining forever tight. You will continue to reside in the prison house of my heart. So he's giving punishment to Krishna. And then he said, because I'm not going to release you for millions of years. So definitely you are going to get imprisoned in my heart. So this is the mood of Bilwa Mangal Thakur, that he wants to imprison Krishna because of the punishment, because he stole away Krishna, the heart of Bilwa Mangal Thakur. So such a beautiful mood our acharyas have.
Sisi Chaurashtakam ki jai. Thank you Mataji. Koti koti dandavat pranam.
Thank you.
Kidira Mataji. This song is in the meter of Vibhavari Sesha. Little bit Mataji.
Aloka Pravesha. Yes, it's the same.
Yeah, that was why you're singing. I got connected to Vibhavari Sesha too. Mm. Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
No, don't ask me the meter, okay? I don't know the meter. Maybe Hari Prashant knows.
While singing your melodiously, I connected to, I'm humming the Vibhavari Sesha.
Prabhu, can you tell us the tune, the meter?
Hare Krishna. The meter is Indra Vajra, Upendra Vajra, and it's same as the Samsara Dava.
Yes, Prabhu.
Okay, so thank you all so much. So we'll start here.
There is a question in the chat window.
Okay. Do you know when is Purushottam Math this year? This year it's falling in somewhere in September. Exactly, I don't know. Maybe you can follow the Vaishnava calendar.
Thank you, Mataji. Please explain when start.
Oh, yes, Mataji, sure. This is the Adhik Mas, or also known as Mal Mas, or also known as Purushottam Mas.
Hmm.
Comes every 2.5 years. After every 2.5 years, it comes.
Hmm. And in India, Mataji, all the Srinathji temple, the it's a Jula Niyatra, like fruit Jula or vegetables Jula, and then Kaju Draks, different Jula. Srimati Radharani and Krishna is swinging.
This month?
No, Adhik Mas. Purushottam Mas.
Adhik Mas only?
Yes, Mataji.
Mm-hmm.
Not in our ISKCON temple. In Rakshasnath, 7 days, last 7 days, but in Shishi Vallabhacharya Pant, Shishi Radha Madan Mohan temple, I have seen.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. A small quick question, if it doesn't take time. Mm-hmm. Mataji, at the end of the session, you explained that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was giving his own bhakti, his own Krishna prema. He was distributing it to all others. Bhakti. Yes, Mataji. So was it received the same way by every person, those who were receiving it? Because you said he doesn't see the person's eligibility or what it is. He was just teaching.
Mahaprabhu doesn't take into consideration someone's eligibility or qualification. But now, I'll take my own example. Mahaprabhu is giving this mercy. This mercy is everywhere, like a rain cloud, right? The rain is being showered. The rain of mercy is being showered by Mahaprabhu. Now, if I am holding an umbrella or covering myself in a room and not exposing myself to the rain, then whose fault it is? It's my fault, right? So my patra, my vessel is full of holes of all the anarthas. So that's why I'm not able to hold the rain of mercy that is Mahaprabhu's giving. But Mahaprabhu's mercy is just like a rain. It's there everywhere. Now, it's fault of me that I'm not able to receive it because my vessel is full of the holes of all the anarthas I'm holding in. You getting my point?
Yes, Mataji, because we also read that even in Kashi, the Mayavadis, they changed into chanting Hare Krishna.
Yeah, we read that whole chapter, how the Varanasis were turned into Vaishnavas. So Mahaprabhu is giving it to everybody. Now it's up to us how we are taking it to it. If we are really stubborn, we are really adamant, then definitely we'll not be the recipient of his mercy. And how we can be the recipient? As Radhanath Maharaj always says, that the true recipient, a grateful heart is actually the true recipient of Krishna's mercy. So we have to be grateful all the time.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, so if there are no more questions and comments, we'll stop here. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for your wonderful association. And thank you so much, Haripasha Prabhu, for being on the call. It was a very nice, pleasant surprise. But at the same time, now I'm feeling quite embarrassed speaking in front of me, of you. So please forgive me if I've committed anything wrong or spoken something wrong.
Beautiful, beautiful class, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Okay, let's pay our obeisances. Vancha Kalpataru Vishcha, Kripa Sindhu Vayevacha, Patita Nam Pavane Pyo Vaishnave Pyo Namo Nama Anant Koti Vaishnav Vrindhi Ki Jai Namacharya Shadharidas Thakur Ki Jai Shri Rupa Goswami Ki Jai Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Ki Jai Shri Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami Ki Jai Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Ki Jai
Ki Jai
Ki
Jai
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Radhe.